Catherine Hobart.
Dr. Brock Holt. I went to Harvard.
Right this way.
I say right this way.
Okay. Obviously with a severe case of hypertrichosis, a.k.a.
I was once arrested by a dog catcher.
Hey, here's one thing that is contraindicated to any treatment we prescribe. Self-pity. Oh, what conditioner do you use?
Oh, worth it.
You and I are getting along just fine.
I'd almost given up hope before Dr.
My word.
I wouldn't get her hopes up. She's incurable.
You want to try? Well, then you have to.
Brock's kingdom or King Brock is king. Discovering as I go. Sometimes I just stare at my hands and cry. I was up at the Mayo Clinic when I got post. Dean Munch saw my layout in Playgirl 10 Hottest Doctors, and she offered me a gigantic signing bonus. No. I'm the recipient of the world's first complete hand transplant. A real hand. I'm the genius, not the hand.
How'd you lose it?
Super Bowl accident.
You played in the Super Bowl?
Super Bowl party accident.
It was Super Bowl 49. I was working in the hot vent, still haunts me. First, the power goes out. Next, my idiot friend running, and I can't go to sleep with a dirty house, so I started doing the dishes. The soap must have lubed up my hands because my Harvard class ring fell off. Did I tell you I went to Harvard? Well, I did. Harvard University. Anyway, my ring fell down the drain. I stuck my hand down to retrieve it, not realizing that Maddie had turned on the garbage disposal. Then, the power came back on.
God, that's horrible.
No, that wasn't the worst part. You see, once in every generation, a surgical prodigy arises. That prodigy is me. At 23, I was the head surgeon on the operation that separated the Hemsworth brothers. It made the procedure so difficult. But no one else could do the job. I was the best. Got my hand and I couldn't get a job. Being banned from baseball in his prime. I knew I could still do it. I mean, yes, I still see the patients, and don't get me wrong, I'm a genius at solving medical problems, you know, connecting the dots. And it's why I owe Dean Munch for finding me and giving me a second chance. What choice do I have? This place is my last chance. If it doesn't work out, I've got nothing. You say deserves got nothing to do? There's nothing we could do.
No, this is an issue on a chromosomal level.
Right.
It'd be like asking us to make your eyes blue. Or me warm.
Actually, that is my job. The Craigslist ad said uplifting male.
Right now! I've never been so okay, I promise.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, Dr. Brock.
Bunch of research, and I think we may have found a way to treat and possibly cure.
Text and send. Somewhat invasive and all, could provide a little relief.
Big decision, and we don't want to rush you, but as this is an experimental procedure, if you do decide to move forward, we're going to need you to sign this.
What are you doing here? You scared the crap out of normal body, man. That fact number one, hirsutism can be caused by polycystic ovary syndrome, but Catherine hasn't complained of any abdominal pain or regular pain.
Of egg omelet, no yolks, just whites and canned tuna.
Per se. I mean, all those foods is very good. I should be on that diet. It's good for dudes. Boost your testosterone. Testosterone. That's it.
Testosterone.
Your diet is extremely high in vitamin D. It's boosting your spike your estrogen and bring your hormones into balance.
Your boobs will probably get bigger.
Hydrotestosterone. It's a byproduct of testosterone. It's what causes hair loss in men. See, if we can introduce enough DHT into your system, well, you'll lose hair naturally, the way a man would. Most men, really. Yeah. Here's a compelling solution now. Ready to idea first.
Oh, so, Dr. Hot, just to be clear, you're saying that our idea is better than Zayday's idea?
Yeah. In this case, I would.
Awesome. Popcorn they sell and have them covered.
I don't understand why. You are the most incredible woman I've ever met.
is amazing.
Sorry, Randall, but there is no known cure.
Incurable.
I'm in.
You should be at school by now. You should have graduated.
Actually, I'll have been playing a couple years.
Whose hand is that, bro?
Anonymous donor.
You're wrong. Because guess what?
I realize it takes years.
Back off, Chanel.
Back off me. This hand is capable of a lot more than playing squash. So now you know my secret. There's zero scientific evidence of any transplant recipient exhibiting behavior related to the donor. Usually it spasms and sort of gives the appearance of a life of its
own. Box this up, I'll be able to fix it with one hand.
Okay.
Sure. We don't have to do the transplant. I-